Hello YouTube. Well, I said a few times I'm very clumsy and accident prone, and I was busy with my cakey experiment. I put some in a Kokodama style bowl. Those are the cakeys for my Dendrobium Kingianum, and these are some very small cakeys I took off, and both of them I had in a separate bowl with gel beads, and they're making new growths and new roots. So I made a Kokedama style, and I mounted this one upright. And as you can see, the pseudobulbs didn't have leaves, just had a few old dried up roots, and I put them in soil beads, and all of them making tiny new growths. So I put them on a tiny piece of wood upright. I just need to find some fishing line, but I wanted to water a few of my outside plants, and I dropped this one. It knocked over and it fell out of its very ugly semi-hydroponic cup, and it was in Leka. It was a little bit too high on the Leka, so I used I don't know how you call those wires. You use them for your bin liners. I put them with some skewers, tried to hold them in the pot, and I just wanted to show that they're doing fine. They're making loads of new roots. I only saw that one and another one. Oh, there you go. But underneath, there's a lot of new root growth. So I'm see if I can clean it up a little bit, because there's a tiny bit of old media on the bottom. And then I'm going to put it in a clay pot with the same leka a little bit lower and some leka on top. So sometimes when you have an accident, it has a lucky outcome, because now I can pot it right. I just have to be really careful with those new root tips, because I don't want to break them off. And so yeah, I'm gonna pause now and let you see the end result. Bye, be back in a second.
Hallo, ik ben Jen en ik ben mijn moeder aan het helpen met sorteren.
Okay, she said, "Hi, I'm Cheyenne, and I'm helping my mommy sorting out the leca beads." She is using one of my new tweezers to sort through. Oh, wait, there you go. Yes, and so she's taking out the big ones. Anyway, oh, wait, it's so hard to have depth perception while you're videoing. I took my new tweezers, and there you have a very small point, so I can get into the roots and clean them without. Wait a second, say what?
It looks like a six.
It looks like a six indeed. And how old are you?
Six.
Cool. And so I can get into those root bulbs without disturbing the roots. And yeah, I really needed to film Cheyenne because she asked me to. I will put pause now and see you later. Okay, so here's the finished product. As you can see, I put it in a clay pot with leca beads, and I put back the skewers because the root ball is a little bit too shallow to keep it in place. But I was really careful with the root tips. I didn't move it around, so I think in a few weeks, if it grows a little bit more, stabilizes in the pot, and I don't need the clips anymore. This is one of my uncle's dendrobiums, the one I told you that he inherited from his mother and his grandmother, so my great grandmother, and it's making keikis. It's making new growths also. And I'm not sure if I need to take the keikis off to make sure that the new shoots down get more energy. I will wait till they have more roots and take them off, because I'm not sure if it's okay to how you call that? Diverse that much energy into keikis. I have more than enough keikis. I have more than enough offspring. So, if I'm gonna do that, I will film it and keep you updated. So this is my happy thing with the accident. I get to repot it in, well, get to do that over. So this is my Dendrobium kingianum repot. Thank you all for watching and have a nice day. Bye.